all my techniques for when I used to have to follow ATP when I was not on their team. So, Josh is back there. Yeah, so I use the Zwift Companion app a lot, and I just find key people, and I just watch their watts per kg. Like, these guys are all rolling very, they're at like 1 watt per kilo. All right, they are close. So I'm gonna start my engines here. I see them coming. I'm gonna start bringing up my speed. They're coming in pretty hot. Here they are. Right, we're in the block. Find your prey. I found it better luck when I was hunting in the lobby to find one person that was around my level. And finding them and trying to get on the back of their wheel. Alright, looks like they're going at about 38 kph. Alright, it's about 400 meters from here, a little more. About 300. Alright, you see the intersection ahead with the green signs at the top right. At the end of that intersection, there's a crosswalk that's 100 meters to the start. I'm going to go pretty much full force pretty quick. From here, and I'm gone. No way. This is like a totally different beast. Looks like they're stopped. So the next sprint is at 3.2. I put a link on Facebook, it's a YouTube video. Try to end some more. Thanks, dude. Tracy. Just gonna tag all you guys. Okay. Tracy, what's your name on Facebook? Is it? Okay. I just tagged everybody on the link to the YouTube video if you like while we're resting. Peek at it. It's pretty cop job. I did it in like half an hour just before this whole thing started. there's a certain anxiety with like, oh, that's another thing I do. So I open a companion app, I go to Zwifters and I find somebody, and when they're not pedaling, under their name, it'll just have a lightning bolt without any numbers. Once they start pedaling, the numbers will pop up. You know, it's kind of hard to focus on what the number might be if you're moving back and dancing around. But you can see the lightning bolt on sort of companion. That's kind of my. See, some of them are still soft pedaling. I don't know, they're just kind of digging around. But it's not accurate. You know, don't trust with companion too much, because like right now it says Bender is going at 1.4. I also keep my rear view camera on in my perspective on Swift. But you have to remember you're in it when they start to approach you, so you know, you gotta be able to switch out of it or just don't worry about it. Well, that could be the case. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, no, great. But it's not like up to date. So if you follow it in a race, like you could be in first and it shows you're in 10th because you're in lap. And then all of a sudden you're off the back. Zwift Companion shows you're in first and you're off the back. So it's not a great fine, you know, I want to say fine motor tool, you know, fine thing. Yeah. 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 All right, so the next one is exactly the same distance to the centimeter. It's Castle Park Sprint. Verse. It's 322 meters. I think it takes. Hopefully, it'll pass me. It starts at 3.2. Gosh, I'm going to catch up. 8 seconds behind. Got me on this one. So you enter some box turns. It's a left into a square, you know, square shaped turns, and then a right and a right and a right. After the second right is the start. It's hard to describe. Alright, once you make the right, there's cars parked on the other side, there's a bus on the left. Here you go. Go, go, go. Next one comes quick, by the way. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I see you, Ben. I'm going to creep up as well. My prey is Josh Erickson. Not the first time my words got me in trouble. Ben actually helped me a lot. He was right in front of me and I did okay. That's all good. Now I got six. Honestly, today I just have to not get last. Even if I got last today, I would actually do well for myself. I have a 57 point day. I'm kind of knock off. You are about 5 seconds behind me, so you're like, you know, you're, all right. And then Tracy's ahead of me, and Steve's ahead of her. So I'm sticking right to this guy, Josh, like a very annoying fly. Make sure I give him a thumbs up. Yeah, well, these two were particularly close together. The next one, there's not long, but it's about double the distance in between, so not sure. Yeah. you know, the next, I was just going to say, this one's a 30-second effort, just so you know, so it's longer than the last two, but not by a huge amount, but it is, it's not just one of those, like, give it everything, you really have to measure yourself over 30 seconds. Okay. Okay, it looks, I thought somebody was rolling. I had the guy that's in my crosshairs got on his bike, but got off. Haha, 2 minutes then. I like this nylon character. Okay. All right. All right. Okay. See the go go. We got credit now. we have lead out credit for days. ATP will not be doing that. That's right. Gate that's in front of us, that equals less than 200 meters from the start. Less than 200 meters. Yep. At the left turn ahead of us, it's less than 100. I'm going max when I hit pavement. I'm going. I can't tell if they're still paddling. I think they're paddling. Soft. Alright, stopping. Yeah, maybe before. They keep creeping little by little. I think you might be right about going into the bridge. Everybody's sort of creeping up. I don't think they're stopping. I think they just tried to sneak away. I'm catching up. Now there's a group stopped at the fork in the road. Yeah. Dude, he's actually back by the bridge. And Richard Carter is even behind him. So, they're pretty spread. Although now my guy is moving slowly up. He's almost to me now. Yeah. Alright, the next one is the longest sprint in all of McCurry Islands. Unfortunately, I don't have the notes on how long, but I think it's between 30 and 50 seconds. It's an uphill approach, the railway. Yep, railway sprint forward. Yes, it starts at 7.8. There's two inclines before getting there. There's a big sweeping right-hander curve that marks, you know, the approach. And as soon as that, it looks almost like a parking garage turn. And it swings to the right. Once that finishes, that's when I start building speed. I don't try to hit like a huge max power because it's so long, but I do really put on gas after the parking garage turn. Parking garage turn should be around 7.5. Okay, so you're talking about the hill before it. That is the previous hill. There is one more hill. So yes, when you join the railway, that's the prologue. Flattens out, and then there's one more turn. I do believe you're right. I think it's like a negative one. I know it is a little bit of a descent, either right before it or during. holler out if they start. I'm just looking at my notes here. Yeah, it's a -1, -2% approaching the start. So come up the hill, parking garage curve to the right. It goes -2%, -1% through the whole segment. So even though it's the longest, it'll keep your momentum better than this. Entrance speed than everybody else. Although you don't want to just be everybody's drafting bitch too. Yeah. Yeah. I have the arrow. I'm thinking of using it like right at beginning. No, I'll do it right when it levels out. Oh, are they moving? No. Creeping. No, there's just one creeper. Oh, there's a few creepers. I think it's just the back of the group moving up. Richard Carter. He just wants to ride my wheel. Like, I'll draft you down if you let me grab you in. Alright, so around this left, he has a 6% incline for about 600 meters. This is the one of two. Okay, levels out for 20 seconds, 30 seconds. And there's another similar hill. That hill ends. It's 100 meters to the start. Very soon, less than 150 meters away. Ends after the right-hand turn. You're not going to believe me, but my lungs actually feel better now than after the first sprint. Nope, that was the last one. Man, if I didn't lose a group on that second sprint, I might have taken first today. Yeah, no, all I had was Ben. That's all. He was my dude. Yeah. Yeah, definitely saved the race for me. Cool thing about snow being the lead out. We can call you Snowpiercer. That's right. There's so few people. That's right. This will be some of the highest placing that some people will get. Because, you know, it's probably a beautiful day in a lot of the world right now. Yes. Yeah. Yeah.